Figured out. Okay. I think Nikki should be here fairly soon. Sorry for the constant time changes. We thought we needed to postpone until later today, but then some things came up and now we are just gonna go ahead and do it now. Okay. I seem to be, not seeing things the way I should. Oh no, that's not good. That's not good. Okay, so it is on. It signed me out of my YouTube account. I'm not sure what this specific song is called. The track list is in the description, though. Just depends on what timestamp we're on. 6 minutes 15. I think that would be this one then. There you go. Okay. How's everybody doing? Everyone's doing good. What's up, Nick? You guys aren't getting double audio, are you? No. Okay. Okie dokie. So, as the title suggests, we're gonna do kind of an informal second part of the collection tour, because I've had quite a few people who have reached out asking when it was going to take place, and I just have not done it yet. And that's one of the reasons I'm going to address the current state of the hobby, because that has a lot of why, that's a lot of the reason why I haven't done it yet. I've been very hesitant to do anything with the collection stuff where it's going to showcase... Oops. Stardew Valley's on. Turn it off. Where it's going to showcase, like, the value of things and the expense, because I don't want to get clumped in with people that are being blamed for ruining the hobby because they're making things about money. And it's not that I'm making, you know, my collection about money, but some of the most frequently asked questions I get involve money and what I've spent and what stuff costs, but it'll be nice to do a little bit of a live with you guys, because then I can actually go into old Kanto eBay and show you what I paid for things, because prices have changed so drastically. Let's move that so we don't see the keyboard. We don't need to see it. Stop shaking now. I'm not helping it at all. It'll stop. So how's everybody doing? What's everybody been up to? Fun stuff? Cool stuff? Let's get eBay up now. Kanto eBay lore. Don't cite the deep magic to me, which I was there when it was written. Purchase history. Okay. So I just want to get this pulled up and make sure that it's not going to, like, show any personal information. 2019. Okay. Cool. It doesn't. Oh, God. Terrifyingly cheap. Everything was just cheap. Oh, you guys are going to cry. So, Nikki and I got into the hobby, obviously, at a fairly good time, just because we got in before, you know, a lot of super famous people decided that they also wanted to be involved. Aw, man, it's gonna make me log in. Oh, gosh. deep cut Narnia reference. Love to see it. Straight chillin'. Good, good. Straight chillin'. We like to chill. Ugh. Struggling here with my vertical keyboard. I think that's my password. Uh-oh. You guys can't see that, right? Thank God. Oh, no. Oh, no, no. Okay. Purchase. Wait, wait. Why does it keep changing? Not the last 60 days. We don't care about that. We want old stuff. Alrighty. So, I've got that pulled up for in just a little bit. But I said in my description that I wanted to show you some of our binders. I want to show some non-TCG related items and how those fit into the collection. And talk a little bit about the value of non-TCG items as well, because that's gone super weird over the last 12 months. I'll touch on our original collection goals, like when we first started collecting, and why it's okay for collection goals to change over time. You don't really need a reason for them to change, but a lot of people feel like they can't change their collection goals once they've started collecting. It's, well, I wanted to do this, and I don't want to just not do this because then people are going to think I'm wishy-washy, or then I'm going to look like I'm not a serious collector. Not true at all. Everybody changes their mind. And how the current state of the hobby has affected me personally, how I have seen it affect the community, and show on and show forth. But just, I guess we'll start all the way back at the beginning. The very beginning. Let's see if I have the card. Let's see if we have it. Before I begin, though, is there questions that anybody has that they would like me to answer during the stream? About collecting, about Pokemon, about my personal collection, any of that. Oh, snappity dappity. Un momento. Okay. I have a lot of our stuff in different places than it would normally be. These are here because they were either going to be graded or autographed. So, the card that started it all. There she is. All right. The bane of my existence. This is the card that started everything for Nikki and I. I found it on Facebook Marketplace. Don't remember what I was looking for, but it sure wasn't Pokemon. A nice gentleman had this and a first edition Dark Blastoise from Team Rocket for sale. He was only asking $50, and I messaged him and I was like, "Aw, I haven't had Pokemon cards in forever." And I just was like, "I live about an hour from you, it says, via the map, but I would love to come pick this up tomorrow." And he was like, "I'm going to sell it to you because you're the only person that didn't ask me for pictures of the front and back and at all these different angles." And I was like, "Sweet," because I knew nothing about collecting. And I was, at first, I was like, this could be a chance for Nikki and I to earn some money and get some of the stuff we want to renovate the house. We'll buy this Charizard and sell it because I'm sure it's worth millions. But obviously it's not worth millions, and once I held it in my hand. What, honey? Why are you so upset? Oh, goodness. Come here, you want me to hold you? It's a hard day, huh? I know, goodness. Once I, like, got the cards in my hands, I was like, I can't sell these. I can't. Then we started buying cards at Walmart, like the GX boxes and stuff. And it was just game over. But it was a Charizard that got me back into collecting. And got Nikki into collecting, period, because she had never collected. I'd love to know the first card you got that you really had to hunt for. I think it's in here. Oh, here's the other one. No? Yes. Maybe? I think it was first edition was the one that I got from that guy, but maybe not. Now that I'm looking at it. Hi, baby girl. Is it a hard day for you? I know. Okay, those... Not it, not it. I think it's in Nikki's Mewtwo binder. Yeah. I think it's in her Mewtwo binder. But when we first started collecting together, we wanted to complete master sets, and at first I was like, I want to have one of every single English Pokemon card there's ever been, period. I want to have all of them. I gotta catch them all. And very quickly I realized that that dream was not super achievable. So, we've been doing our best to get master sets of things, but it hasn't always been, like, at the forefront of our minds to complete master sets. But, oh goodness. We gotta resituate the camera here so you guys can actually see. Alright, Aspen. Hey, sweetie, will you see if Aspen wants out? Let's do... Duel. So there's a lot of missing cards in here. Just because of... ones that were supposed to be autographed and stuff. I think these might be nope, these are not extras. It's back in here. This is the first card that I ever had to hunt for very hard. I think I paid like $19 for it, and it took me forever because this artwork is used, I believe, more than once, or similar artworks are used. And back in 2019, it was very difficult to find obscure Japanese cards. So this is actually like a Game Boy promo, which is very strange, but it's an absolutely beautiful card and was 100% necessary to her collection, obviously, you know. But a lot of the Japanese Mewtwos were kind of hard to find. There was a jumbo of hers that was pretty difficult to find. I'm still looking for the inverted stamp version of this card. I obviously don't have, you know, $7,000 to spend on a PSA graded one, because that's what the last one went for, I think, was $7,500. Why can't we get cool promos like that, right? Some of these are custom. These three were the first custom cards I ever bought. Bought them from somebody on Facebook. I knew they were fake. I wasn't, like, expecting them to be real. Then this was the first one I purchased from Zaba. Zaba cards. Very beautiful card. Oh, I haven't looked through this in a long time. Then we have her duplicate Mewtwos in these last pages. But I don't want to go through the whole Mewtwo binder until she's here, because it's been a while since she's looked through it, too. But one of the things that I like to do with collecting is collect my favorite Pokemon. So, I'm sure you guys know who my favorite Pokemon are. Those of you that know me. Those of you who are here because of the thumbnail. The Charizards come later. First and foremost, we'll go over my newest favorite Pokemon. This binder is just so large. We have struggle time, okay. It was water she wanted. Both and out? Okay. This binder is too big for me to put it with my mic. So I gotta do like this. Bulbasaur, yes, Bulbasaur is one of my favorites by far. But Dragapult is my newest favorite, so I have started a beautiful Dragapult binder. Now, this is a binder that I learned about from SlangTangPoke on Instagram. 12 pocket binders. I think this looks phenomenal. Not just because it's Dragapult, but I don't know, something about it being four columns makes me very happy. So I have more than I need to put in as well. I think they're in here. Pretty sure. Maybe not. Maybe I moved them. They're somewhere. I had so many of these sleeved and ready in card savers, ready to go be graded, but then CGC still has not graded my first submission, which they received in January. So, needless to say, I'm not going to be using them for a long time. But I tried to put these in order of, like, little guys to big guys, and then these are just the Japanese ones. We have yet to pull any of the Dragapult from Shining Fates. Well, Nikki pulled a Dracloak. So it's a small but mighty collection right now. I wonder what light that's picking up on. Because I don't have a light on in here. Thank you, thank you. So happy you guys think it looks nice. Are we like super, super delayed here for something? Okay. Give me this. Thank you. Dang. It's on normal latency, that's why. I wish I could change it. Can I change it? I was wondering why everything seemed so delayed. Hey, a red folder that's like that put Sword and Shield base set and Rebel Clash in it. Hell yeah. Okay. But then I put some... Oh, did I put anything else in here? No, it's my other one. Okay. So, Dragapult will fill this whole thing, I'm sure. At some point. He just needs more cards, and we need to pull more in English. Period. But... to get a little bit nostalgic with you guys, we'll go... This is my very first special binder. This is where I used to keep all of... Look at the dog hair. All the cards that people would send me with their, like, trades, or when people would send me stuff. I would keep all the signed cards in here. But there's no fitting them at this point. So we had to put them on a bulletin board. And move some things around. Here we go. So, some blank pages, cool. Because I took out the signed cards. These are just extra cards that people had sent me, like with trades and stuff, or custom cards. Some, can't remember who gave me those. But these were cards, actual cards that people had sent me, not that they had signed or anything. So I have them in here because they're special to me. Some stickers. Oh, my legend cards. We never finished the legends. Kind of sad about that. Oh, I got excited. I thought that was Nikki. I think we need, like, some chill vibes music. I can't remember who gave me Frosted Caribou's card. I know it wasn't her. Can we get, like, chill music? Royalty-free chill music. That is actually listed as a thing. Oh, but I don't want a yoga advertisement first. Okay, there we go. There we go. Chill beats. That's what we need. Chill beats. You haven't missed much, my friend. We looked at my Dragapult binder and that's about it. I like how this has a price sticker on it. I bought this at the Dallas Regionals that we went to in January of last year. Oh, my Shadowless podcast set. It's not complete. It's missing so much. I stopped after a while. My boba collection. We'll start here. I don't know. I feel so awkward for some reason. It's my Bulbasaurs. I know ringed binders make people cringe a lot, but my cards are fine. At one point I tried to have these in like sequential order, but I was getting them at such like varied rates that it was very hard to keep everything organized the way that I wanted. But the first birthday I had after we started collecting, Nikki got me the entire evolutionary line in this reverse holo from Legendary Collections, and I sobbed because I was so excited. Get some more Bulbas. I need to finish. I'm looking back now and I'm like, why did I not finish these? There's just so much to collect that you just get lost. And that's a lot of times why collection goals change. You might start collecting cards, but think later on that you like something else better. So you change what you want to collect. I do have my... some of my first edition Shadowless in here, because they were going to be signed. But gotta get them. Where'd they go? Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. Hindsight is 2020, and to this day, my biggest regret is losing out on a Gold Star Umbreon by $1.50. I kick myself almost every day for that. So these guys are in the binder. This was going to be graded, not signed, because Kensugi Mori did this artwork. This one I wanted to get graded too. This was the first Shadowless holo that I bought for me. I had bought them for Nikki, but never for me. He's so pretty. Chunky frog. That's why I don't buy Pokemon cards. Cost too much money. They're so expensive. We have so many random incomplete pages too. Yeah, the crimped ones. I have my error binder we can go through as well. The Umbreon EX from, Fates Collide? So now I always go like $10 above what I think my maximum would be on eBay. If I'm like, okay, I don't want to spend more than this, I'll just go $10 over that if I want to put in a max, but just to show these before we put them back in this little box. And then we'll prop this back up so the glare goes away. There we go. Been there with many, many things. That's part of collecting, too. You know, you live, you learn, you love, you loss. These winner cards, the best of promo, best of Black Star promos, were some of the funnest things to, like, hunt down. Don't know why, but I was so excited to finally have something super specific to look for that wasn't just, like, a Pokemon. Oh, Dave's a good boy. Aw. Okay, special story time about... This guy. This was my first trade ever. Sorry, I skipped a page, but this was the first trade I ever did. And it was with, I think, Pokemon Trainer Green on Instagram. I was so paranoid. But I got it. So I start to my little Venusaur page. I only have three Shadows, Hollows, Nidoking, Gyarados, and Venusaur. Well, since you mentioned the Gary boy. Oh, wait. So I can't, like, scroll as I interact with the website? No? Let's see. Yeah, no, I can't scroll. I wish I could. There's no way to search, I guess. So, I'll just read it to you. December 20th, 2019, I purchased a Shadowless Gyarados holo on eBay for $12.50. Crazy. Crazy. Most valuable card is Misty's favorite full art from Unified Minds. Yeah, the female trainers are going up a lot because of guys. Honestly. This is the expedition in the E-series is like some of my favorite artwork because it's when they first started to like step out of the box, I think, with their artwork. The first time stuff would look super cartoony or like 3D clay type stuff. A lot of these are missing. Either they're in my tin here or I don't have them for the collection yet. I have the full art for this. I don't know why it's not in there. Oh, such a chunky boy. I wish they would pick, like, different poses. They seem to like this open mouth Venusaur, and they don't make him do anything else. That was the first collection I ever really wanted to finish, was my Venusaurs, my Bulbasaurs. But I never did. Obviously. Never finished it. There's my little Bulbies! Oh gosh, this was what started off as all of my evolutions. What's up, Ralph? Hope you're having a good day too. But I had to switch it up and put them in a different binder. So Eevee and then the first three evolutions take up this whole thing. And then the other evolutions are here, along with the duplicates of other things. I was a super fortunate childhood friend of mine gifted me a near complete set, base set unlimited. And the Gyarados happened to be Shadowless. Ooh, that's awesome. Venusaur cosplay is Hungry Hungry Hippo. But I guess we'll go through Umbreon since she's here. Always loved Eevees, always loved Eeveelutions. First full art trainer from your very first booster box you ever bought. Aww. I think she was one of our first from a booster box. But our very, very first one was Kahili. The golfing lady. Ugh. So beautiful. Two cards that I will probably never have are the gold stars of Umbreon and Espeon, because they are just absolutely ridiculously expensive. And I just don't see how it could ever come into my possession, quite frankly. Very expensive. Very, very expensive. This isn't technically an Umbreon card, but she's front and center, so I think she should count. Espeon. I used to not be a super huge fan of Espeon, but Espeon has grown on me since I started collecting, too. Oh, I have more. Venusaur needs a better art.change.com. We started a change.org petition. So, some that are missing from there to be graded. I purchased this for $30 at a card shop. I think that's about a $300 card now. I would have to check. Then I got the first edition Umbreon Hollow, along with like 10 other Hollows from Neo Discovery for $90, and I'm sure this is well over that at this point. But the Dark Espeon is one of my favorite cards of all time. Easily. Easily. Umbreon is best evolution, hell yeah. And they're both super clean cards. Beautimous. Oh, my first fake card. First fake Espeon. I have almost all the Espeons. The gold star is one I'm missing, and I'm not missing many others. Pretty strange, but Espeon was like one of the cheaper options to finish out first. Espeon, as well as Leafeon, Glaceon. I think I have most of theirs too. I don't think I have added in the promos from the... Oh, no, it's right there. In the box last year. What evolution do you normally see female, male? I know it can be either, but do you naturally see more feminine or masculine? I think... I just call them all she's. I've always just seen them all as female. We've got Glaceon. There's, I think, one that I don't have in here because it's with a different set. But there's this, but it has a snowflake right here. Not a lot of Glaceon cards. Sylveon. Again, I know that's not a Sylveon card, but come on. How can I not? She's so cute, and she's there. That's so cute. Sylveon, definitely a boy. I don't know. I mean, I think the only one I have really ever seen as masculine is Glaceon. Can't see why. Oh, more Sylveons. There's my duplicate Eevees. I started keeping every Eevee that I ever pulled, and, like, I'm not kidding. I have so many Hidden Fates Eevees. Don't ask. I don't know why. So many. This was the first pack of cards I ever bought at a Party City. Gosh. This is going to be such a long stream. I apologize. Like, just for me sitting and showing and talking. It's going to be long. So many EBs. World champ card or regional champ card? City championships. Oh. Now we're getting into the Vaporeon dupes. Jolteon and Flareon. If any, yeah. So cute, so cute. This is one of my favorite Vaporeon arts. So nice. So pretty. I'm glad you think it's worth it. I wish this was hollow, though. I don't know why they ever thought it was okay to make Vaporeon an uncommon, but Pokemon, don't ever fucking do it again. Okay, we're watching you. You're on thin fucking ice. Probably my favorite Flareon artwork. Cosmic Eclipse just fucking slaps, man. People sleep on that set. Little Jolteon. So cute. Oh, goodness. Let's not fucking bend that one. They used to be in order. Mew! Oh, here we go, here we go. Look at this. My baby. So, this is signed by Masakazu Fukuda, who's the artist of this card, and about 400 other ones. We chillin', no worries, enjoying your collection tour. Enjoying this tour through your collection journey so far. Thank you, I'm glad. This promo, Hidden Fates, man, this is wild. Vaporeon's your favorite evolution? Vaporeon used to be mine when I was a kid. It was Jolteon for a little bit, then it was Vaporeon until I was an adult, and then I was like, nah, it's Umbreon. I remember not long after I started collecting, I really wanted a bunch of these. I was like, I just freaking love them. And I would like to see if I can get one graded as a 10. So I got a bunch of them. I think I have 6 or 8 still sealed. I have one being graded right now. Then I have this one. Just such a dope card. They gave this out at the movies when Pokemon, the first movie, came out. So freaking sick. I wish they would do another one like this. Light Jolteon is one of your favorite Eeveelution cards. All the lights are super, super pretty. 100% agree. This is obviously a custom. It's actually metal. Very hard. I think Glaceon kind of looks like a Boy Scout. I can't explain why, but I think it kind of looks like a Boy Scout. Oh, gosh. So, I guess I have more Ancient Mews in here, and that's what that is. Oh, no, it's a sealed promo. A different sealed promo? I'm not really sure, to be honest. Probably Ancient Mew? No, because it would say. That one's a sealed one. Oh. That's my favorite Mew card. Hands down. So beautiful. How long did it take to learn how to say some of the artists' names? It didn't take super long. I tried to find most of them on social media and couldn't find hardly any of them. But Mr. Fukuda, they said his name a lot at regionals, so I was taught how to say his, I guess, but I feel like I still mess up Mitsuhiro Arita because the I-T-S-H-U in his name, like, throws my mouth. I can't form it. I'll send you a painting I did of Light Jolteon if you want. It's still sitting on love. Oh, I will love it! It'll go right next to the little painting of Ancient Mew you did. It's sitting front and center. Right there by my Arcanine statue. The little Ancient Mew you painted for us. Is there an ad coming, or is there just, like, somebody speaking in the background of the slow jazz music? These promos, too, I wish they'd bring back. The full art, but not really full art. Let's take this baby out so you can see. Hello, Pokemon. We're about to get to the part that you want to see. I've looked and looked and looked for the error version of this card, because there's a lot of them that are like that, where the holo is like, it looks like it's been torn, but like torn and then you enter a different dimension, not like the card is damaged. That's a hunt I stayed on for probably 6 months and then finally just was like, I can't continue to just look for this fucking card. I'm gonna go insane. But Mew's one of my other favorite Pokemon. My Gengar and Alakazam collection is embarrassingly small. I'm forever salty that we have not seen a Gengar Alakazam tag team, and probably won't unless we see it in like the V union thing. Full art Pikachu with Galar starters is an awesome card too. 100% yes. One of the best promo probably on the planet that they've made with a figure collection. I would have to agree. These two guys Nikki got me for my birthday, the first year that we collected. Such a mischievous little guy. Just weird designs here. It's like they look like colored blood cells behind him. Alakazam is best Pokemon ever, totally unbiased opinion. This Gengar is like the first edition Japanese version of Aquapolis, I believe. And I think it's called Wind from Sea. Aquapolis was called Wind from Sea, maybe? I'm not sure. Obviously, I'm missing some Gengars. I didn't put the promo from Champion's Path in here. But it's one of my favorite cards. There's quite a few Gengars that I know I don't have in there. My Alakazam one I did update today, though. With the V. The Burning Shadows Gengar as he comes through the wall sideways. Is that in here? I don't think he's in here either. Yeah. I gotta finish out Gengar, because he's pretty easy. Alakazam is just so fucking majestic. We all love a spoon boy. Look at them spoons. So, you cannot really tell, but that is a holo. Oh, there you go. You can kind of see it. That was another birthday gift. Five. Top right. This isn't Burning Shadows. That's Crimson Invasion. Oh. Favorite card of all time. One of them. It's in the top 10. You cannot deny the beauty, the grace of that full art. So nice. I think, what was it, five Legendary Collection Reverse Holos Nikki got me for my birthday. The first year we started collecting, plus like three or four PSA 10s. If that tells you how cheap stuff was. I mean, you could just buy it. Now you can't. Oh, and then I have a little Abra. So cute. I don't think... Yeah, I used to have my full art trainers in here, but they didn't fit after a while. Oh. So we've got Primes, Level X's, and Early EX's, which I need to put elsewhere. So I'm going to shut this. And we'll look at these. No worries, Brian. I really thought that there was one in Burning Shadows. I didn't open much of that set. Oh, goodness. You'll excuse me, that's an eBay alarm. Don't judge. Ending soon. Sorry, I'm about to snipe this card. Don't judge. We got like a minute. And I know I'm not gonna pull it, so I gotta just jump while I can before it gets real expensive. Just wanted to stop by and say hello. I'm working late, probably be to like 10. Dang, Justin, what's going on? Did somebody else wreck one of your old rental cars? We're on pause because Kanto's gonna snipe someone on eBay. Maybe. Hopefully. Want it so bad. Thank you. I will reveal what it is after, even if I don't win. Gotta catch up on stuff, that's all. Okay, well, I hope you have a good day and make sure that you get plenty of rest and drink water. Get wrecked. No fucking way. Please. Oh, thank God. Okay. Had to. After how many booster boxes of English and Japanese, still no Rapid Strike Urshifu VMAX, we ain't pulling it. It's not gonna happen. Have a wonderful night, Brian! Got him! More than I wanted to pay, but, you know, whatever. Yeah, it's from Battle Styles. The blue one, the blue guy. Nikki and I both really wanted that card, and I just couldn't pass it up again. Oh my god. Hello?
Did you just say, are we at your house?
What? Yeah. What?
Somebody just texted and said, are you still at my house? And I said, yes. And I thought, well, Nikki, we're not at your house. I don't know who this is. I need to get my glasses.
It's not me. I didn't text you.
Okay. I thought it said Nikki. Okay.
Was it my wife?
Yeah. I bet that's who it was, Nick. Hold on.
Let me look at this. Oh, your mom and Hayden stole it. Oh, Nick, it was Nikki. I know it was. She just sent me a voice message, but I'm trying to...
She said you and Michelle aren't answering.
I know, because I'm trying to do something.
Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
It's okay. That's why I wasn't answering her. I didn't know she texted me.
Okay. All right, I'll let you go. All
right, I love you.
Love you.
Bye. I feel like I sound like an absolute douche, but... My brother called from my mom's phone at like 3:30, because he got out of jail. So he was like, he's gonna come to the house. And he was like, I'm gonna go home and shower, and then I will be over. And then it got to like 5:45, and I was like, where the fuck are you guys? I didn't, like, I have things I need to get done, and I don't wanna just sit and wait in limbo. And I know that sounds bad, but I'm trying to get back on my normal upload schedule and stuff, and that me having to cancel / postpone, not knowing when I'm gonna be able to like pick up and continue, was frustrating. And my mom was like, no, he hasn't even taken a shower yet, he was on the phone with somebody. I was like, okay, so when are you guys gonna leave? Probably 45 minutes. Well, no, can we do tomorrow instead? She was like, yeah, that's fine. Michelle, where's your phone? Next to me. I responded to her when she asked me. She texted my mom, and my mom called me. Who is texting me? Asking where I am? Look at your phone. I don't know who's texting you.
Here. And I said, no. And I said that there
could
be more.
Yeah. Django. Well, I feel bad. I know he wants to see me. I know he wants to see Michelle and Nikki and everything, but he also wants to call 1,000 people and do 1,000 other things. So do that and come see me later. Come see me tomorrow. I'm not going to be bothered. I just want to know when I can get things done. And Nikki said at 4 o'clock that they were cleaning up and going to be on their way home, so I don't know why she's not here at 7. Yeah, where the hell is she?
Then they probably have them go do something else afterwards.
Where the hell are you? Well, no, because I told her to come home. I said, can you come home early because Hayden's coming? Because my mom was going to take him to rehab tomorrow. Jeff says Django needs a hug. Do you want to give him a hug or should I give him a hug?
I would give him a hug, but Kylo says no.
Django, come here. You want a hug? Come, come. Oh, I got snubbed.
Here, Kylo, give him a hug.
Django. Django, you want a hug? Aww. Michelle hugged him. Him got hug. Almighty. So... these, we got all of them from the bulk boxes at our card shop. I've showed these on an Instagram Live before, some time ago, but the card shop that we frequent, where we get used to get a lot of, like, really, really good deals, they used to have these giant boxes of stuff from early, early Wizard of the Coast era stuff all the way up through... Diamond and Pearl, where they would just dump in a box because they didn't think anybody wanted it. And that included Primes, Level X's, early EX's. And so when we would go to, like, check out and say, okay, this is what we want, we'd have a stack of, like, 100 cards. And the guy would just say, I don't want to price all these, so $30. And it'd be, like, $500 worth of cards. Like, okay, that's on you. But the Primes were some of the first. They're not in great shape, the Primes, but they're so beautiful. I wish they would bring back the silver border. I know a lot of people have also had the same sentiment towards the silver borders, like from Japanese cards, wanting them to come to English. But these are just phenomenal. So pretty. I think there's an Umbreon Prime. I want to say yes. This was a trade on Instagram I remember vividly. Guy was so super sweet. He packed that thing like it was Fort Knox. Sandstorm Raiju, yes. A little zappy boy. So we probably paid like $5 or $6 for all these. And this isn't all the EXs. We have some elsewhere too. Not all of them are in good shape. They kind of look like they are, but some of them are real fucked. I'm trying to think. Some of them I know are creased, but I can't really see because of the glares and stuff. Yeah, like the Hitmonchan is creased at the top. Power Keepers, Crystal Guardians. Promos. They don't make them like they used to, guys. If anybody is, like, super interested in pricing information, I can look up some stuff. Just let me know what you would like to hear ballparks for. And I have just some random Level X guys here. I have a lot of these that I have not sorted. In the other room. And then this random thing from Boundaries Crossed. I don't know. Don't know where I got it. Why I have it. But I like it. I like the Ace Spec cards. And they're super playable. And expanded. And they were much like Prism Stars. You could not have more than one in your deck. But like, you can have a Tapu Koko Prism and then a Thunder Mountain Prism Star stadium card. For the Ace spec, you could only have one in your deck, period. Not just one of one type, but, like, one and that's it. They're insanely powerful cards. Eevee. My watch is scratched all to hell. Oh, hold on. How do I... don't know how to... Hold on. I don't know how to send just a voice message on my watch. I just realized you said you guys were cleaning up at like 4 o'clock. It's 7 o'clock. And you're not here. Are you okay? Did you guys have to go do something else? Are you lost? Did the car break down? I just like seeing the beautiful collection, hearing the stories behind it. Well, thank you. This would be a lot less messy if I... I guess I should have called Nikki and told her that I was streaming. And told her that my mom was not coming. Reconnect, reconnect. Okay. Alright, the binder says it all. We're going to Eevee's now. Scoot this over. Put this here. Okay. Uh-oh, hold on. Clicked out of something and... Well, I guess I don't really need eBay and stuff up since I can't scroll to show you guys. Okay, so this is my Eevee collection, which was one of the things that I really wanted to complete this year. And I think I still might be able to because I don't think I'm missing a lot of expansive cards. When I say Eevee collection, I don't obviously mean all the Eeveelutions. It would just be Eevee and the main three, because as we discussed earlier... The gold stars are expensive as hell. I have the gold stars for the first three evolutions. It's just Espeon and Umbreon I don't have, so it'll be harder to finish. They're not in this binder, though. They're with my Eevee shelf in the other room, which I think was shown for the main collection tour, but you guys have seen them 1,000 times because they're my signed cards. I've only posted them, like, once a month. For the past year and a half. Eevee. Plain and simple. One of the best Pokemon on the freaking planet. Is she a fox? Is she a cat? Is she a dog? Who knows? But she's the greatest. Some of the cutest artwork. Some of the most diverse artwork for a single Pokemon. Like, very different range of, I guess, poses. Some are very dynamic, some are very still. Not always making the exact same facial expression. We've got sad Eevee, we've got happy Eevee. Eevee with the ball of yarn Eevee. Weird Eevee. We got a chunky Eevee at one point, didn't we? Yeah, there she is. Weird, cursed image. They need to just stop making all these new cards because we're going to run out of room. I already don't have any more room for Eevees. And they've made Eevees. I don't have EVV in here. Oh, gosh. That was one of the last shinies we pulled, I believe, from Hidden Fates. When we were, like, opening it on the channel and stuff. Absolutely nuts. S4. What is that? Pokemon King, what's up? We just doing some little nostalgia runs through the collection. We're looking at our old stuff and also, oh gosh. You know what? I just need to call her. I'm gonna call her on my watch. Recents. Gosh. So, she didn't have her glasses on when you text her, right? So, she calls me. Are you texting me asking where I am? No? What? Someone texts me asking if I'm still at your house, and then I was like, what are you? She kept breaking up. I couldn't understand her, didn't know what was going on, and it just scared me because I'm trying to stream. I'm doing, like, part of the collection tour in a live version going over binders. I thought you would be here because they were going to come over, and then Hayden decided to, like, make a bunch of phone calls and stuff, and he still hadn't even taken a shower by, like, 6 o'clock. They said they weren't going to be here till after 7, so I said, just come tomorrow, because I have stuff I have to do. I had this live stream planned, and yeah. I wanted to be able to get it done, because I had pushed it back to 7, thinking they were going to come right then, because he called me before 4.
Yeah.
But I'm going through the binders and stuff right now. I haven't gone through yours. I was trying to wait for you to get here, but it just keeps getting later. You're almost home now? You're breaking up really bad. Oh, okay. All right, baby. I love you. Bye. Sometimes it's like a blessing and a curse when I don't realize what time it is, because then when I realize what time it is, I panic. Because I just realized, like, she texted me 3.5 hours ago saying, she, or 3 hours ago saying she was gonna be on her way home soon, and then she still wasn't here. You know, my brain automatically goes to she's driven off a cliff and is in a ravine somewhere and needs help. I'm gonna have to take this stream down and edit it, because it's just been a clusterfuck. But just like I was saying with the variety... Oh gosh, don't fall over, keyboard. Stay up. The variety of the Eevee. Here we have sad Eevee. Happy Eevee. Not really sure. Determined Eevee. Surprised Eevee. Whereas Venusaur just makes the same face all the time. Oh, there she is. She's coming. I'm so excited for you guys to see her go through the binders, because it's been so long since she's gone through them. Vaporeon has some of the best artwork in the TCG. Hands down. Light Vaporeon. All of this artist's work. Kagemaru Himeno. Beautiful. Adorable. Fantastic. Love it. So cute. Oh, Sky Ridge. Cute. I wonder if that's a holo. Is that a rare? It is a rare. Do they have a holo? I'm sure they do. So many. Let's see if we can get the zoom in part going here. telephoto. And then I can just move it around. Instead of trying to hold it up. Django is screaming because Nikki's home. I did once I saw the text and listened to your voice text and realized what time it was, I was like, what the fuck has happened? What has happened? She texted me 3 hours ago and said she was gonna be home.
I forgot we had to put the oven back in and the microwave. And the lady wouldn't shut up.
As usual.
Did she smell like onions?
Yes. It smells like an old folks home.
How long has it been since you've gone through your Charizard and Mewtwo binders?
It's been a while.
It's been so long. Are you so excited?
Yes.
I'm so excited.
Can I change?
Yes. Thanks. Jimeno, I love his artwork. My top favorite Pokemon is hell yeah. I love Snorlax. Just has life figured out. Snorlax is a mood.
He does. He's best.
He's sleepy boy. The Delta Species cards are another one of, like, the best one-offs they've done. They tend to do something weird and new and special every generation or so, and this was one of my favorites. I still don't know what Delta Species means. Don't know why it's special, but super cool. Beautiful work from Heart Gold, Soul Silver. I feel like Vaporeon has a lot more artworks than a lot of the other evolutions, so we'll go. Oh gosh. You guys can't see that one, but there she is. Sometimes Vaporeon looks like she doesn't have a soul. Sometimes her eyes just look dead and scary, like Coraline. Here we go. Then the modern stuff, which we love. Generations Vaporeon, one of my favorites. I wish they had texture. I don't know why. I feel like the texture would make it better. But I do. I feel like maybe there is a full art that I just don't have. But I had been leaving spaces to fill in. I had filled in a lot of these from the bulk boxes at the card shop that I was telling you guys about. But I know I think I'm still missing some. Like, I've randomly put in promos for some Pokemon, and not for others. Like, the Sword and Shield promo for Vaporeon I did put in, but I know I haven't put in the Jolteon or the Eevee from Battle Styles because I haven't opened them. Didn't put in the Eevee V, none of that. Oh, so nice. So cute. Jolteon. Where was it? We were at a card shop in Indianapolis, I think. Where I was going to purchase the Reverse Holo from Legendary Collection. The guy wanted like $115 for it. And I was like, abso-freaking-lutely not. For your moderately played evolution. It's no deal. No deal. Generation's top fave set for sure. I thoroughly wish we were around when it was out so we could have opened more of it. To appreciate it for what it was. But the first couple times I opened it and started getting Radiant Collection cards, I was super confused. I didn't know what they were. And I was like, I'm not about this. I don't know what it is. And I don't know why people like it so much. But I think this being an anniversary year and really understanding like how big of a deal it is, I have more appreciation for it now this year than I did when I first started. And I wish that I had not torn through so much generation stuff. We still have, I think, two full pack art sets of Generations. And I think that was the last set to give us five different pack arts. Because there was... Oh, wait, no. Was there only four? No, it was only four. Venusaur, Charizard, Blastoise, and Pikachu, right? So, yeah, just four. JK. Chilling Rain was going to give us five pack arts. For some reason, Jolteon cards are always hella cheap. I feel like Jolteon doesn't get enough love. Some funky artworks, though. Do they not have teeth? I'm just now wondering. Where are your teeth? What are your legs doing? Which way are they going? Look, I'm thorough with Jolty. I only got regular, we got reverse hollow, we got non-hollow. Oh. Teeny tiny Flareon collection. The Pop Series 3 is one of my favorite artworks. Just with the ears, very cute. Radiant Collection is my favorite. I wish I was collecting regularly during Legendary Treasures. When the first Radiant Collection came out, was it called Radiant Collection when the one-off that they had for Generations 2? Or was it not called that? Oh. So cute. Little fire puppy. Jolteon is right next to Umbreon for me. Never cared much for Flareon. I never really liked Flareon too much either, but we gotta give props where props are due. Some of the Flareon art is just phenomenal. These are so cute. This one is so amazing. These cards I'm not like a super big fan of. A lot of the black and white era cards feel like they were trying to dip the 70s into Pokemon. I'm not a fan. Aww. Speak of the Devil. Radiant Collection. From Generations. Beautiful card. The little string of heart gems there. Yeah, two sets of Radiant Collection now. Alright, I think Nikki's gonna come in here, so I need to switch how we have this. Oh wait, hold on. Okay.
It's not my turn yet.
It's not your turn yet. I was going slow. We can get the new chairs though, or the other chairs. What happened to your toe?
Oh, I ripped the skin off the top of it from our back door yesterday. Jeez.
Do you want... I can take the stool.
I don't have the stool. Do you want the stool?
It helps me sit up straighter if you want to have something to lean on.
Oh, I don't care.
Okay. We gotta resituate.
Resituate.
Yeah.
Let me put that down.
Yeah. It's shining on you more so than me.
Yeah, and I'm pretty...
It's pretty pasty.
Yeah.
Like, there are two of the Shiny Vault sets. Is it still called Shiny Vault and Shining Fates?
I rubbed the no skin on the bottom of your, whatever you call that thing.
Desk.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna scoot this over like that. Okay. All right. Everybody can see us okay, yeah? Or at least Nikki. I know I can be seen okay.
Amando. Or Amando, since it's over there now.
And there's just some random little extra guys in here. Hi.
Are you on YouTube?
Yeah, I'm on YouTube. Now we're done. And she left. Okay. So. Put this here. Oh gosh. Oh. SV card, the cards are labeled SV. Oh, I didn't notice that. Where did, there it is. Okay. So some of the Mewtwo's and Charizards are missing from the binders. Like I said, because we were going to get them
graded
and signed.
I don't want you up here, buddy.
It by various artists and whatnot, so. What do you want to do first, Charizard or Mewtwo?
Hey, Jeff the Ref. He's on top, so let's go with him.
Oh, heavy boy. We have some other sets in here, too, right now. It's not like we have 8,000 Charizard cards. Okay. I think we got this binder on Amazon. Yeah, we need to change the...
The what?
Change it and then we'll bring it down there. It's in your way, isn't it?
I can see these.
Oh, okay.
I don't need to see them on there.
That's true. I didn't really think this through before I decided that this is what we were going to do today because we didn't have a video.
The door is why we don't have a video. I had drama with drywall screws yesterday. Just
drywall drama.
Oh
gosh, baby.
Your trash stick on me. Still.
So I'm gonna...
Some of them are in the... Whatchamacallit, too. Are in the case out there.
Oh, that's right.
You want me to go grab them?
If you want, or I can grab them.
Yeah. I'll never remember where they go.
Right, you start talking about Charizard. And your cards. If you remember where we got them, they like stories.
Yeah, sure. I remember. Yeah, 100% remember where all of these came from. All of them. I don't remember where any of them came from. I do know that I got in trouble for getting two of them. Because the pictures were deceiving. Very deceiving. I can't find them. I'm not gonna... This is her job, not mine. This card? I don't know what set it is. This is one of my favorites, though. Can someone tell me who the guy in the card is? Because I don't know. I just like the card. Did we take the first two out?
Your shadowless ones?
Oh, yeah.
Or the shadowless and then the unlimited base set?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they are out here. A booster pack! I put them like that.
They just casually toss the shadowless and legendary Zards on the top of the binder.
These... This isn't the Charizard. This is Charmander and Charmeleon. Radiant Collection. Thank you, Amanda.
We were just talking about Radiant Collection.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
He's licking the bottom of my feet.
What a weirdo. Kylo, can you be normal?
I do not want to take... the shadowless out of there.
I do.
I don't.
Watch. You That's almost, why the tab's on it.
Well, yeah, but you almost crushed a Charizard card
did,
before.
But I didn't crunch it. I decided not against crunching.
It's in pretty good shape.
Pretty boy. Ain't no PSA 10, though.
Yeah, it's not a PSA 10, but still, pretty good shape.
We had been watching several auctions trying to finish our Shadowless collection, our Shadowless set, and we ended up with a couple of the Shadowless Zards that we got for 200 or less. Ooh, all of them for 200 or less, which was nice.
I bet those people are kicking themselves in the pants now.
Well, I was looking back at our eBay stuff. Shadowless Hitmonchan, $10. Shadowless Gyarados, $12.50. PSA 10. Armored Mewtwo promo, 30. Mewtwo Reverse Holo Legendary Collection, 35. PSA 8 Shining Mewtwo, $100.
Oh, one of the auction sites that I follow and check, they have a Gold Star Mewtwo.
It's not graded. It's raw. They said it'll probably grade between an 8 and a 10, depending on who the graders are. Blah, blah, blah. All that stuff. I didn't see any noticeable stuff on it. But right now, it's at $600. Yeah.
We paid $252 for the first one. And then $150 for the second one.
$150 for the second one.
Little spicy boys.
Yeah, but he will be the man with the plan.
Very nice, very nice.
I don't know where I got any of them. I will remember. Oh, we all know this. I was excited about this like 2 weeks ago. Yeah. I was excited about this.
A grail piece.
Yes. When she says grail, I have been looking for this card for at least 2 years without spending, you know, $1,000. And I got other ones with it for less than $1,000, so.
I'm excited about this Charizard.
Yes.
So, for those of you that watch, follow, or know Jordan Fringe, I brought him his Snap Station because I told him about the one that was at the card shop that we go to. He wanted it, so that was I brought that to him, and he showed me his card like this, and he said he's never seen another one like it. All that, they're from like some obscure collection box from like very early 2000s, and I was like, I want it. I have to have it now. So I spent a long time on eBay searching, and I found it. And then I found the collection box that it went with. There's a Mewtwo one as well. I found the Charizard and the Mewtwo. Was able to find doubles of them, so I sent them to Jordan, and he got those as well. You're welcome, Jordan. I helped you with 3 Grail pieces. Do you plan on keeping the cards raw, or are you going to get them graded? Yes, we are going to grade them. They are going to go to PSA, though, because we want them to match her other stuff that's already graded.
I like stuff that matches.
Mm-hmm. So it'll be a while since PSA is not taking new stuff. I don't know if we can grade this, though.
Why?
I don't know if they grade lenticular cards.
I don't know why they wouldn't. Well, it's kind of hard, huh?
Yeah, from the metallic Tomy Zard set. Mm-hmm. Alvin Hex is on it. Alvin Hex, the resident toy expert. So, we've seen these. Nikki got these two boys, plus Rockets Zapdos EX in an online auction with some other stuff for like $90. It was insane, because
I forgot that you could check your eBay
purchase history. Alright, so we'll start going through some Zards here. I'll just be page turner.
See, I don't remember where we got everything. You do.
I tried to have these in order, but they might not all be in order right now. They've been printing a lot of Charizards recently, so we're obviously missing some. 700 packs into Hidden Fates and still haven't pulled the Charizard, you know, not salty about it at all.
Well, let's go all the way back here. I do have a lot.
Do you have the non-holo version? From Dragon Majesty? I'm sure we do.
Non-holo from
this one.
This one?
Yeah, I don't know if we have the non-holo. We might just have it in the... We probably do. I just don't have it in there. I know we have them with the set.
I really like this card.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We are missing one Full Art Charizard EX. It's from the Generations collection box. I feel like we look like we're sitting in a hole.
In a hole?
Yeah.
I'm up a little bit.
I don't know, you can't see a lot of us.
Look, I'm almost as tall as you. Why am I here?
And I keep looking at you through the screen instead of... It feels weird to turn my head that far. Sorry, Chapstick, I know.
Lots of it. It's very much more silky than mine.
There's the Japanese version of the Dragon Majesty Charizard. These are just duplicates of the Zardy boy. Oh, the V is actually supposed to be up there, but we've got our fake first edition shadowless.
Yeah, our fake first edition.
In a beautiful little Japanese EX. Then we get into her little baby spices. These are spaced accordingly to
sets.
What we're missing. So. And then I stopped spacing them, apparently.
This one is one of my favorites.
You have two PSA graded over there on the shelf.
I know I do.
She has
we did have three.
The craft.
We sold one.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Because we have so many.
Yes. You did lose one for a while, too.
But I found it.
We found it. Straighten it out and...
I can't.
Oh. Okay.
I'm going to move it too much.
Okay.
But I really don't like how this looks. I'm just going to say that right now.
Well,
I think it looks
make
dumb.
Yourself taller.
I can't.
I'll make myself shorter. I can't. Oh, there we go.
I just don't know how I want this. I guess we can try... Hold on. Move your hand. What a clusterfuck. Today.
But then you can't get both of us.
Yeah, I can't.
It's because the phone's at an angle.
I love you. That's how I felt with the purchase of the Kanazawa set. Pikachu, my electric disciple, for under 200. Yeah, the Pikachu alone, over 300 right now.
For under 200.
Crazy.
Yeah, I'm not very good at finding stuff like you are on eBay, so I'm not even going to look for it.
You all have the sealed Charizard promos from boxes and whatnot? No, we don't have all the Charizard stuff. Not at all. Charizard's expensive, and we don't fuck with that.
Yeah, Charizard's way more expensive than...
And she doesn't really like Charizard that much.
This is the guy I actually like. I like Charmeleon. It's just... Charmeleon's hard to come by, honestly.
Yeah. I forgot to show the Charizards that we didn't have in the binder, because they were either out there or they're elsewhere to be signed and graded. So we have Shiny Boy. Gold Star Shiny Boy. Shining Boy.
The
Charizard. Oh, we got this for $40.
$40 because we think he entered it wrong into PSA.
eBay.
Or eBay or whatever. And you can't see it real well. I don't know how to get it up there.
You can't even... Okay.
They're right there.
It's creased.
It's creased, but we have one for $40. You can't beat that. And I know I got my name on it, but I don't intend on selling it.
I'm not mad that you
not
got
you,
your
I'm
name.
Talking to them.
Charizard again. Base set, and then base set to... Team Rocket.
I do like the Dark Charizard.
And then the Shadowless Boys. Oh. One of the Shadowless is back over there already. Another unlimited base set. Okay. Now we can go on. I forgot about those.
I forgot about those.
Oh, this is
yeah,
be
I
fun
like Charmeleon because he's the angsty little troublemaker.
Angsty little troublemaker.
We're the Charizards that I got off a proxy bid.
In a tin over here?
We're in a tin.
If you move, I can get them. But I need you to back up so I don't run over your toes. Oh, I should have planned this better. At least I put out content today, right?
Hey, you know, there is such thing as being real people and, you know, forgetting things. So, you know.
There's another one.
Another one. Yes. And this one. The pictures were very...
misleading.
Very misleading. Or doctored, one or the other. You know, I'm not an expert. I can't look at that stuff. But I love this card. It's just not in the best shape. This card came with it. And this card.
No more holding back. Let's see your Bidoof set. We ain't got no Bidoof. Bidoof. No Bidoof. Yeah, I think this is the only auction of stuff that you overpaid for. Everything else has been like...
I overpaid then, but I'm sure they're worth more now, damaged or not.
No, they're about what you paid for them now.
So we're good. We're broke even.
I don't understand why, though. Like, these cards, like, the damage value has not gone up as significantly as the other Charizards, but... it is making sense to me. Then this is the Japanese promo for the Illustrator contest that was this past year.
Yes. You want to explain the Illustrator contest? I don't know if everybody knows. No.
I don't know how to explain it. There was a contest and this guy won.
That guy won the contest.
He won. Another freaking Charizard. What an ugly card. Ah, Zukon cards.
I love
so
this
cute.
Card.
Wow.
Do we put the Zukon cards that we got with your Umbreon?
No, they're over here.
We haven't, like, sorted a whole bunch of stuff.
We haven't sorted anything in, like, a year.
Yeah, like a year.
And this entire live stream is just making me realize it.
Yeah, we sort our commons, uncommons, and stuff. The stuff that we, like, get
it's
rid of.
The same fucking one.
The bulk. Is it?
Yes.
Oh, now I got two.
Now I'm mad. Fuck!
It's not the...
Why are the numbers different?
That's not the same one.
The numbers are different, but it's the same exact card.
It's the same picture. Do we see the difference, everybody? There's, like, clouds over here, and, yeah.
Weird.
It's a different picture. It's a different background, same picture. Heracross,
yeah. Heracross. I liked the Ash's Heracross, how it would always try to suck nectar out of Bulbasaur's bulb. I thought it was funny. Then these are just, like, vintage dupes. Oh god, I gotta add these to the spreadsheet. Because these are the dupes. These are all of our dupes. Oh, she's shadowed. Wow.
So pretty.
And then our top stuff.
Angsty grumpy boy.
Oh. I was super into the tops cards when we first started collecting, but I haven't been into it. But I'm gonna just really quickly, because I'm talking about it, touch on it. When you collect something, whether it's Pokemon coins or whatever, your collection goals are allowed to change. And they're, no one is gonna think less of you as a collector, and nobody should give you shit if you stop collecting one specific part of Pokemon and start collecting a different part of it. There's so much stuff in Pokemon. It would take us so long to go through our entire collection of stuff with you, because we can just sit and tell you why we got stuff, how we got stuff. She doesn't think she can, but she could tell you where she got so much of the stuff. Stuff that we hunted for, like, just looking back, we can think.
I do know at least three people that you know personally and you've told me about, they have changed their collection route, you know?
Yeah. You gotta get what you can. Welcome back, Justin! But the tops I was super excited about, and I wanted to get all of them. And then I just, all of a sudden, was like, I don't like these.
No. There are a lot of tops cards, too.
There are. So I have, I think, three complete sets of tops. So Series 1, Series 2, and then the movie. And they're super nice, they're cute,
they're
but
kind
like
of trippy.
Yeah, they're not my fave. Were you able to get the card you were trying to get earlier? Yes.
What were you trying to get earlier?
Oh, gosh. Because I don't think we're going to pull it. I know you want it. I know I want it. And I know I just, I spent too much
chicken
money
chicken?
On it.
Oh.
That card? Yeah. That's an awesome card.
Yeah. I overpaid it for it. Because I just realized that it says it's damaged. Because they spilt something on it. It says wear on the top left, but I don't fucking see it.
Maybe on the other side? You didn't read the description until after?
I didn't see that, no. I looked at the pictures thoroughly. Zoomed in and everything. I was like, this looks like a good card. Because most of the battle styles full arts look like they've been chewed on.
And she gave me shit for overpaying for damaged cards.
I like collecting the mini tin cards, but they change them, they don't connect to form a picture. Oh yeah, that's right, they change them till they look like they have a picture frame around them.
Well, that's disappointing. I do like that, though.
Yeah. The backs of some of these are super cool. Vader, get out!
He was laying.
I know he was. My patience is gone. Oh, we don't have to go through these. These are not my favorite. There's so many. If anybody wants a couple...
What are die-cast cars?
The, like your Charmeleon. Where it's cut funny. The die-cut cards.
Oh!
She doesn't... I've bought her so much...
Cars.
That's what they...
Cars.
Oh, I don't know.
Cars.
Oh, cars. Why are you asking me? I don't fucking know.
I wasn't asking you.
Oh.
I usually don't talk directly to them very often, but, you know, I am right now.
Cute. Okay. This
me
done.
Too. And put that back. That over there. Get this out of the way. Here. No. Please don't.
I think I'm going to hurt it. I'm just trying to put it somewhere where it's not going to fall.
I know that, and I'm putting it up there out of the way.
Vader, shut up!
This is our life with the dog. She didn't shut the door.
Yeah, she knows you collect Hot Wheel cards, but she doesn't... Cars. She just doesn't know what a die-cast car is. Yeah. That's what she's asking.
Is that the one where you can take it all apart and everything like that, or...?
Okay.
You sleepy?
Yeah.
This is just pretty. And he has rabies.
I'm waiting for you to talk about your cards. This is your binder.
We have all the dupes in here. We don't get rid of Mewtwo cards. And she's joking. I don't remember where we got all of these. I did get that. This is the one I got, though. Rocket's Mewtwo. Yeah? Yeah?
What?
Mewtwo. No, you got that one?
Yeah.
She is the best finder of anything. So, we have our shadowless boy right there. Where is my... There it is. This one. Is that the one I got? Mewtwo's Return. That's one I found.
Yeah.
Yes.
Rocket's Mewtwo EX.
It was a steal.
Yeah, what, $30 you paid?
$30. She said I was crazy. I had to show her. And she goes, bid on it. And no one outbid me. No one sniped me. Nothing like that. Maybe they spelt something wrong. Who knows?
Could be. That happens a lot when we get good deals on stuff because of misspellings.
Yeah, you're better at talking to them than
the,
I am, just so you know.
This whole stream has been terrible, so. Like, I pause, I say like a lot, I don't know what I want to say. I have too much to say and not enough to say at the same time. All the same freaking card. Why so many versions? Come on, Expedition. And some of these are not even the same number.
Yeah.
There should be two different numbers. But incredibly expensive nowadays, I would assume. I think I paid $19 for the holo. Don't even want to think about what it costs now. $35 for this guy.
And this one, who's a stamped winner. I don't know if you can see it.
Winner. You know. That's an expensive one now, too.
Who's here? We had pulled him out for grading, for signing.
That one.
Where's our other one?
That one.
So, I love this guy because we got him damaged. This is damaged, according to the gentleman who sold it to us. You can't see it. You can't even tell. It's actually not damaged. It is an error. It looks like something got under the ink when they printed it, or under the paper, or under a layer of the paper of the card. So, up here somewhere, there's actually like this bump under a paper or ink. I don't even know if we can show you on the... That's where it is, isn't it? You'd literally have to feel it. He pointed it out to us. So he sold it to
us.
I'm trying
to see if I can see it.
Like, just see it? There it is. Yep. Right there. I can't point to it from...
Right here.
Right there. Hi, buddy. Hi.
It's like there's a grain of sand that got under it somehow.
But he sold it to us as damaged. Maybe he was just in a good mood. Mm-hmm. Hey, buddy.
So we're only missing, I think, three Mewtwo cards for Nikki's entire Mewtwo collection. English. Mind you. First edition Shadowless, first edition Shining, and the stamped pre-release promo for Evolutions.
Oh, okay.
And some of her other Mewtwo stuff we'll go over after the binder, because I have a whole bunch over here in a stack.
I got the diecast now. Thank you.
But we have a lot of these taken out because they're going to be shined. Aspen's fucking outside. Michelle's not paying attention.
I'll get her.
These are taken out because they're going to get signed. Breakthrough, I think it was, had like 10 Mewtwo cards. A little excessive, but no one's mad. So many Mewtwo cards. So many beautiful cards. Not a super huge fan of the Mega Mewtwos. Either version, really. Just not a big fan.
Come on, Aston.
Not my favorites. Mewtube! I'm curious as to what that's currently going for, but it was like a $20 card way back when. But this is one of my favorite modern Mewtwo arts. So nice.
Where's the one, the tag team one?
I don't know, and I wish you'd stop asking me where stuff is.
Sorry.
There's one right there.
Yeah, this one. I was just going to explain it because you like this one.
I know, but I'm getting stressed because I'm realizing so much isn't where it's supposed to be.
Yeah. She likes this one because it encapsulates both of their personalities perfectly. But in this case, I am Mew laughing at her.
Yeah, fucking shit-eating grin. And then I'm just over here like, please, fuck it. I swear to God, I'm going to sock you right in the mouth.
With you, Justin. Just cataloging is just boring.
Mm. Yeah, you don't do the cataloging.
I know, but it's so boring. I help you. I'll be bored with you.
I already explained this guy, the Game Boy promo.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. All your...
The Shadow Mewtwo? Love it.
That's from, like, an Amiibo card, I think.
Yep.
I like this card, too. That's old. Test-Tube Mewtwo is your favorite modern Mewtwo card. It's pretty freaking sick, honestly.
The Test-Tube Mewtwo?
Yeah. Where's our Hidden Fates shiny Mewtwo? I guess we didn't pull two of them, did we?
No. So he's in the binder, regular binder.
He's in the set.
We have...
The Japanese one.
The Japanese one. Does mm-hmm. that count? That's why there's a spot right there.
No, it isn't. These are Japanese cards.
Oh, it ended.
So it will go right here.
For the ones that have been watching...
I think it's going to get graded.
For a while. That Mewtwo was... I spoiled it for myself. I dropped the cards, and that card fell out. So... But we got it. You CP baby.
Yeah. We had gone through, like, what, 200 packs of Hidden Fates by then? Yeah,
ridiculous amounts. Ridiculous.
So much. So we have some of your...
Tops and stuff like that.
Yeah. Some of the older Japanese stuff in here. So we'll go ahead and go through some of these. This is a Zukon card that I've been looking for a dick year, it seems like. I would like to have had the holo, but the holo is so expensive. This is just such a phenomenal artwork. It doesn't even need to be holo for it to look just absolutely breathtaking. Then we've got some sticker card things. Just anything Mewtwo, Nikki will buy.
Even my derpy...
This was my most recent misspelled pickup. It said Pokemon, and Mewtwo is spelled Mewto.
Ah.
Pretty sick.
Yeah. Is that the one I found?
I'm not sure. Pull the shiny Mewtwo GX from Hidden Fates, my third 10. Yeah, we were so far in. I cried when I pulled the full art Jesse and James, too.
Yep.
I wanted that card so bad.
I guess it depends who you talk to.
Is her dick year? Her dick year is pretty long. I feel like mine's pretty short.
Yours isn't short.
He looks constipated.
So, this matches this guy right here. She bought one. I bought one. You know, sometimes she just doesn't tell me. She buys me cards. So, we've both got one.
Pretty. They get all the cool stuff in Japan. Also, please note, the writing on this sleeve is on the sleeve and not the card.
It's not the card.
Very old. Why does Mewtwo come before Mew in the Pokedex?
That's a good question.
Mew's 150. Or Mewtwo's 150 and Mew's 151.
Because Mew has all the DNA of all the Pokemon. So all of them have to be before him.
I think that's a pretty good explanation. And then I took all the Mewtwo cards out of the tops. The top set. I don't know why I all of a sudden got hit with the tired.
This one. Love it.
So pretty. I guess we could turn it like this. Make it a little easier to see. This is... my favorite.
Him with all of his clones.
Yeah.
So tight. Trying to get that back in.
The movie was just amazing.
I agree. The new movie? The remake?
Both of them. Remake, original? All of it. Here we go, Pikachu!
Our Pikachus.
Our little tiny cosplay Pikachu collection.
See? Tiny.
Well, tiny cosplay Pikachu, but we've got... we have quite a few Pikachus, because there's so freaking many of them.
Yes.
These were in order, but of course they've made like 87 new Pikachus since we updated it. Gosh, what a cute little mouse.
Didn't we have a mishap with one of the red cheek Pikachus or something like that? Like, not us personally, but...
Like, what do you mean?
I don't know. We have there's something happened with... I don't know. Don't listen to me.
Rewatching the movie right now. It's a good movie for sure. Oh, Pika.
That's it.
That's all. So, while I'm showing my trainers, my floor art trainers, I will give my final parting words on why I haven't made the rest of the collection tour videos, and why I have not had the motivation to do a lot of that. Other than the reasons I stated at the beginning, like, people wanting to know how expensive stuff is. Also, paranoia with... I'm sure it's not that hard to find out where I live on the internet. I'm sure it would not be, like, impossible if somebody wanted to be a shitbag and try to rob me. And because I started seeing a lot of people getting their houses broken into and, like, Pokemon cards being stolen and people specifically with Pokemon card collections being targeted. This was, like, right after I put out the first part of the collection tour. I was like, I don't want to make another one of these videos. Not only am I just burnt out creatively from all of the drama in the hobby with people, like, the purists who are... Basically, anybody who started collecting before 2020 is like, new collectors are just in it for the hype and blah, blah, blah. Everybody starts their own collection journey at their own time. You cannot say that somebody is just in it for hype because of when they started collecting. If all it took was Logan Paul showing some Pokemon to ignite people's love for Pokemon, and they truly love it, then don't judge them for it. They should be welcomed into the hobby just like anybody else. But there's been such a spike in celebrities and people of influence, you know, having these collections now and just paying astronomical amounts of money for cards that they want just because they want them and not understanding what they're worth and how, you know, the market value works and how grading works and how basically anything in the hobby works. It's thrown everything out of whack. It's made getting a hold of product impossible. Scalping has been terrible. So these are in order from oldest to newest. So this Skyla was the first ever full art trainer back in a black and white set that I cannot remember.
Well, isn't... And like as you were saying, didn't someone try to offer you $5,000 for your Gengar skateboard?
There was a rapper who will remain nameless who offered me $5,000... for my Gengar skateboard because he was able to get the other ones, but there wasn't a Gengar on eBay like right then or something, and he wanted it, and I said no, and he was like, I'm offering you so much more than it's worth, why won't you just take the money, you need the money, right? It's like, no, or my Gengar skateboard would be for sale, like, what the fuck are you smoking? And threw, like, got mad that I would not sell it to him. It was a bad time. I've had multiple, like, verified folks on Instagram message me wanting to purchase things that aren't for sale, and then they get butthurt when I tell them no, or I guess ignore them. I'm sure they're butthurt when they get ignored, but I don't want to be bothered by people trying to buy stuff that's not for sale. Don't be obnoxious. You started collecting floor trainers in February. Ooh. This was started last year, and it was one of the first videos I made this year. I was super excited about, like, finally getting this binder, talking about finishing out the Full Art Trainer collection this year as my main collection goal. Then I was missing 72 cards. Now I'm missing, I think, 48. But back when I was missing 72, it was $1,200 or $1,300 worth of cards. Now I'm only missing 44, 48, something like that, and it's $2,500 worth of cards. So it's like, it's super depressing to think, how have I gone through and either traded or purchased almost half the cards I needed, and now it's still twice as much as I thought it was going to be to purchase it. But a lot of people are sexualizing the female trainers, which is disgusting, and you should be, like, kneecapped if you do that. These are not waifus, these are children, you sick fucks. Literal children. Don't know if you realize that. Lily? She's like 12. When people ask them to ask you to sell them your car, why would anybody just, like, randomly sell someone their car? That's so dumb.
There are rich people who will just do that, just to see if you would do it.
That puts a bad taste in my mouth. Like, you think everybody else but you is so desperate for money that they're just gonna part with things they love? Like, get out of here. But this is something that I'm bound and determined to finish. But they're starting to make more and more full art trainers, which, by God, it's frustrating. There's so many in each set now. Well, this page is technically done. Misty's favor is just in a grading stack. So. I cried when I pulled this card. I remember when Lily's Full Force was a $15 card. I pulled it from a pack of Cosmic Eclipse that Nikki bought off Mercari. She bought four packs for $16. And I pulled her. And I took her out of our set to put in this binder because I wanted her in here. I love this card. I never looked at the Cosmic Eclipse binder. It's big, it's heavy. I wanted her in here so bad. Now it's like an $80 card. It used to be 15 bucks. I'm so pissed. Yeah. I'm pissed, Vader. Hashtag angry. He's like, give me cookies. We pulled like five Cynthias from Hidden Fates.
Yeah.
But I can't pull another Lily's Full Force. We opened seven booster boxes of Cosmic Eclipse. Six booster boxes. I'm gonna send you my... Yes! Oh no, I'm sorry. We did pull that, Justin. The Flying Pikachu. We have not sorted so much of our stuff. It's been a while since they've been updated.
I think the Flying Pikachu's in the set.
We have more than one. This guy, this one, Legacy sent me for free. I just got that one at the card shop when we went with Nate and Marie. We pulled a couple of the Rosas, and I thought I pulled Roller Skater, but I guess I didn't. I thought I pulled multiple of her, but I didn't. I've pulled the Full Art and the Rainbow of the Pokemon Breeders Nurturing online like 3 or 4 times. And it's not a very playable card, which sucks. So here are all of the our little tags for the ones that we're missing. And I had filled this binder before I realized how many more full art trainers they were going to make. I have some hyper rares in here. These are all duplicate hyper rares that we have. And then the Jesse and James is just another dupe. When the character cards came out, I purchased so many. I actually, just got a ball guy as well. He's on his way. Hilarious. I love ball guy in the game. So cute. I got a lot of these when they came out. I think they're super cool. I wanted to have a page of each, but, you know, I was being cheap. And I didn't buy any of the Pikachu ones because I was like, I'm not spending $3 on that when these are 40 cents. Now it's like a $60 card. This was in the group of the EXs that we got. We got for like $20, and this is a $200 card. Beautiful. He's in pretty good shape. How do you get two cameras in a live stream? You have two cameras. Silly Willy. I use OBS, and I have two different, I use two iPhones as camera sources. Can I help you? Would you like to come say hello? Come here. Good boy. Oh, he says, no, you get the butt. Weezing was my favorite character card? Yeah. Look at that. Roxy. The Mimikyu I was just immediately in love with. I really like Acerola, though. I don't think she gets the love she deserves. Great character in the anime. Fantastic. Hi. Needy dogs, man. Some more Zukon cards. Such beauties. The rest of the stuff is just, like, random cards. Oh, the snowflake set. That was another thing somebody said we would never ever find, and Nikki and I each found. We found multiple sets.
Of what?
The snowflake stamp.
Yeah.
So we have like two full sets of it now.
One's sealed.
No, it isn't. We do not have it sealed.
We opened it?
We never got it sealed.
One had the box, still one didn't.
No.
Yep.
No, I didn't ever see a box.
Okay.
I thought we just got two sets. We have like four or five EX cards. One of them is a Tyranitar. Is it the old EX or is it the, like, XY EX? Oh, these guys are in here from, what was that, Legendary Heartbeat or something? Shiny Star V? I'm not really sure. This freaking Rayquaza promo is like $80 now. Insane. Oh, Volcanion gets slept on.
Come on.
Everybody hates Steam Siege, but it was one of my favorite sets when I first started collecting. Look at this art, man. Like, how can you not like Steam Siege? Give me the Steam Siege. I'll take it. We got these Jirachi promos for like $1 for all four of them. It's like a $26 card now. This used to be super expensive, the Team Up Jirachi, because of the ability, super playable. The old EX. The Tyranitar, that's worth a pretty penny. We have six of these Yveltal cards. Because it was Nikki's like all-time favorite card she had ever seen. We have the XY Premium Collection, but we never opened it. We wanted to keep it sealed because it looks so nice displayed. And I think I paid $10 for six of them. And it's such a beautiful full art. The boxes now go for $300 to $400 because there's 14 full art alternate art promos that you can't get anywhere else. Hex Maniac is in there. Lots of them. And there's more random stuff. Aww. Zamazenta! Pretty. Regigigas deserves more love, too. Did Regigigas get a gold star? I don't think he did. I think it was just the normal Regis.
Yeah, I don't think he did.
Get Regigigas a gold star! Well, just like Charizard got one, but Blastoise and Venusaur didn't.
Yeah. I don't think that was right.
I don't either. We were looking through the my Venusaur collection and stuff, and they always make him make the same facial expression. So sad. But it's always nice to go back and look through all of the stuff that we've accumulated over the couple years that we've been collecting. It's insane to see how much prices have changed, how much availability has changed. And it was just hard to want to do a collection tour, the second part of the video, when the second and third parts, because the third part was literally just going to be her Mewtwo and Charizard stuff, and it's so hyped that I didn't want to get targeted as one of the people who was using the hobby for hype or creating too much hype around certain Pokemon And I was struggling anyways with trying to figure out how I wanted to shoot and, I guess, speak in it. Because I tend to ramble. And it's always difficult to do voiceovers because I never really know what's coming. You know? I do the recording, but I never seem to know when I'm supposed to start talking about something different. But we will give a proper collection tour of the rest of our displayed stuff in a video. I thought we would have time to go over the non-TCG items, but we've spent over 2 hours looking at cards and binders. So I think that's where we're going to have to call it, because that's long as heck. But we will do probably two more parts to the collection tour. Because we have all the toys stuff, I'm trying to think. I guess we should do a whole one on non-TCG stuff then.
Yeah, probably.
And then just the last one can be pretty short and just, like, show the rest of the displays.
I agree.
Since we've gone, you know, full out with the binders. There's a new flavor of G Fuel energy drink called Hype Sauce. What the fuck?
Hype Sauce.
Yuck. But I hope you guys enjoyed this little glance into our collecting. It's, I'm sorry that it wasn't as smooth and cohesive as I was hoping, but I don't know, man. Seeing all this stuff brings back all the feels, and then the interruptions, I can't apologize enough for, but life happens, I guess. Gavin, you're coming in right at the end. Thank you for the super chat. Okay, well, that's gonna wrap it up. I appreciate you guys hanging out for so long. I might take this down and, like, edit it, clip it into parts to post, so people can see it without all the goofiness. And by goofiness, I mean interruptions. But I hope everybody has a wonderful night. Thank you all for being amazing and wonderful. We will do Twitch stream tomorrow, but I'm not sure what time. I will keep you guys posted, just because I will want to see my brother at some point. So I hope you guys have a safe, wonderful rest of your evening. And we'll see you next time.